Okay, I'm going to call to order the Fair Rent Commission of March 27th. Ready, please rise and for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Okay. In case of a fire, please either exit the rear of the building or to my left, your right. Go down out these doors, down the exits, down the stairs, and away from the building. Roll call.
Kelly Hemmler, here. Ian Graves.
Here.
Jennifer Briette.
Here.
Linda DeGray.
Here.
Paul Jenuszewski.
Great attempt. Yes, I'm here virtually.
Thank you.
Okay. Approval of the, I will take a motion for approval of the meeting for March, minutes of the meeting for March 11th.
So moved.
Second.
Any questions, concerns, or corrections?
The whole is misspelled. It should be H-O-L-E.
Where are we talking?
So that I didn't it can print be corrected. It out, so. Hole in ceiling. So under five.
Under five.
Complainant's comments should be a hole without the W.
Without the W. Okay. All right. Any others? Okay. All in favor?
As amended.
As amended.
As amended. Aye.
Aye. Aye. Okay. So those are approved. Okay. I am going to read the rules again for the public hearing. We're here. We realize there's a large amount of evidence and testimony offered for this hearing. The complainant will present first, followed by commission questions. The respondent, if they show up, can present and will be questioned. Both parties will be given time for rebuttal. Lastly, the investigator will present. The commission is bound by the criteria of its regulations. Please keep your comments on the complaint focused on the criteria that we must consider. If you have submitted written comments, there's no need to read them aloud. They are part of the record, as the testimony that we will hear and be given equal consideration in our deliberation. Please keep in mind that this is a formal hearing and comments from the audience are not appropriate and do not do a disservice to those that have the floor. The rules of the hearing require that there be no direct debate between the audience, members, and parties. Any questions or comments must be addressed through the chairman. Thank you for your anticipated cooperation in making the process as efficient and painless as possible. So, before we begin, we did receive information from both the complaint and the respondent. And I'm going to ask the complainant to come back up and offer any more information, any new information that you'd like to give us. And please remember that you are still under oath at this time.
Yes. So I'm not sure if you guys had gotten the email that I had sent.
We've gotten all emails, copies of all emails.
Okay. So I wanted to just say that the Bremen stuff, I couldn't find the paperwork that was given that day. So I sent an example of what their treatment paperwork looked like. And I also sent the paperwork from the guy that did the treatment, just to show you, like, that he did say that, you know, I didn't have to remove anything at that time. Just I wanted to show you guys that. And then I'm trying to think what else I sent. Because there was a lot of things I sent. I can't think off the top of my head. I would have to view it off my email. But
okay. All right. So I do have a question, because the information that we got from Bremen was for roach control and not bed bug.
That's not I actually sent you an email that's from Kathy on May 5th stating that they were waiting on proposals for bed bug treatment through Bremen.
Yes, we have gotten that, but the information for the preparation from Bremen was for roach control and not bed bug control. So was your apartment treated for roach?
No.
Because it can happen. All right, that's all I needed to ask. Okay. So because the dates didn't match up, because the information I got, the Bremen was for October 4th, and the bed bug treatment was...
Can I just tell you that might have been for somebody else's apartment?
Because I could be.
I know they waited a while, too, for their house to be treated.
And this is all hearsay, so we don't want to hear what you heard from somebody. Yeah. We need to talk directly to the...
Well, I'm just saying that could have been from something else, not me.
Okay, that's what I need to know.
Okay.
Okay. So we did get the information about the sewer and trash, but that went to effect in June 22. So, and that's been in place for a year and a half now. So, and we finally got information on how that's finally figured out. I've gone through some work orders that were sent to us. How are work orders received from the tenants? Do you have a portal that you go into?
Yeah, it's called Resident App. It's RM Resident App through Zego. That's who powers it. And basically, you go on it and you put what you're telling them you want fixed, and then you have to give a description.
Okay, so it's not put in by any office worker.
They can do that though.
And not by maintenance.
Maintenance and office can actually open work orders.
They can open them, but they don't put them in.
No, they can actually put them in. Kathy's done that a few times.
Okay. So I'm trying to understand that part. Because
like one time with the stove, she had said, I put a work order in for the stove. I didn't put the work order in for the stove. She did that.
Okay. And how did she know there was a problem with the stove? My question.
Maintenance said something to her that the stove is old and basically the bottom burner was like starting to act funny, so.
Okay. How did maintenance know that? How did this originate? Where did maintenance get that information?
When I first moved in there, I mentioned it when the first owner owned the place.
Okay. All right, that's these work orders are.
Because when she owned the place, she didn't have work order things set up and all that. You just told maintenance what you wanted to have fixed, and then he went in and fixed it. When Eagle Rock bought the place, they did the work order stuff.
Okay, that's that.
Yeah.
That clarifies some stuff for me. So, if I were a tenant there, and I was having a problem, I could go into this system, put in a work order. Then it gets printed out by the office and goes to whoever the maintenance person is who does the work. Is that correct?
Yeah, I guess because maintenance says they have a way to get in and look off of a tablet. I don't know. I've seen them with the tablet before, so.
All right, and you don't know this answer, so I can't ask that question to you because you wouldn't have that information. They just have a tablet.
Yeah, I don't know.
With the information, not necessarily able to do physically put the work order in.
No, they can actually physically put the work order in. That's what I'm trying to tell you.
Okay.
They can do that.
All right.
Not just me, that the office and maintenance can actually open them too.
Okay, so if a maintenance person was walking by and you said, hey, can you come here for a second? And XYZ is a problem, he would be able to put that in and then schedule that.
Yep.
To come whenever his next available time would be. Okay, thank you. All right, Ian, questions?
You sent an email on 14 of March, something about the maintenance supervisor came by to ask if Kathy could do a walkthrough.
Yeah, all of a sudden, she literally was asking maintenance if she could, that Friday, so it was like, I think Tuesday of that week, he said, oh, Kathy wants to come do a walkthrough through your apartment. I said, for what? And then he's like, I don't know, and he asked her, and she said, oh, the town told me I have to do that.
Okay, that's my biggest question.
Okay. Jen?
So I'm wondering if you could go over again the issue that you had with, you made a partial payment and it was rent only and not the utility payment that you wanted to pay separate yeah. from the rent, and what the issue was with that.
Well, because I have a set budget every month. So what I was trying to do is, like, in the first week of when the rent's supposed to be paid the rent. And they weren't giving, like, an actual, because they don't give a due date. They give a time or amount and just the when the bill came out for the billing. That's all they give you. And basically, so I'm trying to, like, gather my thoughts here. So okay, so basically what happened was is I was going to pay, because I'm on workman's comp, so I get weekly checks from workman's comp. So basically I was going to pay the following week, and then all of a sudden I went back in because they send you like emails like bugging you. So I'm like, what? I paid my rent. So I went in, and all of a sudden it said it was minus out of the trash and sewage was minus out of my rent.
So they applied that payment to the trash and
yes.
the utilities first.
Yes.
Was there a repercussion for you? Was there, because the rent maybe was late,
I borrowed from a friend some money until the following week, so to be able to, you know, pay everything, be okay. But it, like, so basically, when they first did the trash, I signed my lease and I didn't have a bill come out for almost like 3 months. So I didn't, and Kathy actually lied to my face and told me that the trash and the sewage were not going to be added into the lease because they hadn't figured any of that out yet. And that basically she was like, you have no worries. And then that the first time, I'll bring this up too, about the floors that she brought up last time, that's when that was brought up. She said that she would, how would it make Christy feel if we did the floors over for you?
So there was no late charge or anything,
no,
though,
for
this?
No, because I had my friend help me, so I didn't have that happen, because it's a $50 late charge.
Okay, that's all I have.
Kelly?
I'm good.
Paul, any questions?
I do. One of the questions I wanted to clarify is for Christy, is it your understanding, as it is mine, looking at the contract, that rent and fees are due on the first of the month?
I actually know by law it's to the 10th of the month you have to pay rent. I was told out of an attorney's mouth that one time, so.
Okay, be careful. The rent is due on the first of the month. You cannot be charged a late fee until after the 10th. That's all that means. Okay. That's all I have. Thank you.
Okay. I do understand your ledger, because we were supplied a copy of it, and it shows that you have no late fees on it. And it did say that the trash and sewer was going in effect on June 1st, 2022, but it didn't show up on your ledger until November. Prior to that, how were you being charged?
I wasn't being charged.
So it wasn't, even though they said it goes into effect, the corporate level hadn't figured that part out.
No.
And it doesn't look like they backtracked and said, oh, well, you owe X number of dollars for those several months that you didn't get charged. So, okay. The information that we got, and I'm looking at these work orders, the first time that the work order showed, and I don't know if you've ever saw these work orders, then I can let you see them, was on, I'm looking for the date. It was March 31st, 2022. And this work order says that for a year and a half, I've woke up by the rain because of the water goes off the clogged gutter and down to the second floor air conditioner and then falls on mine. And it sounds like a machine gun going off. I mentioned this to the old owner and it was clogged. And when it happens again, it's because of this locust tree in the courtyard. They're huge. And so it was that you had some concerns about when the date was. So the original work order about this window in this clogged gutter goes back to March 31st, 2022. And then they said, according to this work order, it was resolved on May 19th, 2022, when they went up and cleaned the gutters off. The next work order that we have a copy of was for June 4th, 2022, and it says, resident reports discoloration in the window frame. Sees black and green discoloration. Clean and evaluate the discoloration issue. Resident did have prior issues with water coming into bay window when downspouts were clogged. And again, maintenance came in and cleaned the window frame. And it seemed to resolve that for you. And then the last one to resolve the window was dated, the order came in for February 6th. I can't see. It's not on you. Of this year, and a bay window was going to be replaced, and they were waiting for the window to come in to replace it, and you emailed and said that was done. Yes?
I never emailed and said that was done. That was Kathy doing all that.
Okay, I might be the wrong person.
Okay.
But the window has been replaced and...
It has not been replaced. They haven't even ordered the window yet.
And you know this for a fact.
I asked maintenance this the other day because it's...
You're not talking directly to the...
I asked maintenance this the other day and it's still not replaced yet.
I'm asking a question because maintenance may not have all of the information that the office does, so you have not talked to Kathy.
Nope, she hasn't tried to contact me or anything with any information.
All right, these are questions, and you're going to have to answer them for us because she's not here. So, all right, anybody else have any questions? Ian?
I do.
Go ahead, Paul.
So we have a record of, I think, 22 work orders that we have received. I believe it's 22 or in that area. They all seem to be resolved. I just wanted to verify with the complainant that those have all been resolved.
The previous ones except the window.
And the window was in progress.
I guess. I don't know anything other than maintenance told me the window wasn't ordered yet.
That's hearsay at this point. Do you know, did you allow the walkthrough that the office staff had requested?
Nah, I actually asked maintenance because he was the original person that did the original walkthrough when I rented the apartment. So he had came back through and did another one with me.
Okay. Was that recently?
Yes.
Okay. That's all I have. Thank you.
Okay, I know there's a problem between personality-wise between you and the management office. But you do understand that legally management has a right to give you a 24-hour notice to come and do a walkthrough in an apartment yearly.
I kind of feel like she's being vindictive,
and
though.
Even if they've never done it before, they can do that. And I don't understand what your feeling is one thing. What reality is another. Legally, they cannot retaliate against you in any form. We've been presented with the fact that other units were all receiving the same increase, percentage increase. So we have issues that have been resolved. So any other questions or concerns at this time?
Can I just ask one question?
Sure.
So we have an accounting now of the rent and the sewer and the trash. Did you have access to that information before?
No.
Okay. So how did you know how much to pay?
They just send you a total and a date, and that's it, like, of when the bill comes out for on Zego.
Okay. So, and what
and
is that?
And it's through email.
And does it break down the rent?
Nope, it just gives you a total and a date.
Okay. But you know how much your rent is, so if you subtracted it, you could figure that out.
Yeah.
I mean, I just want to make sure that wasn't changing. But you didn't know what was trash and what was sewer, because that was just lumped in.
Mm.
Okay, thanks.
I guess I do have another question. The prior management company, you said they did not charge for trash?
No.
Or sewer?
Nope.
So your rent in 2023 was increased 14% plus the sewer and the trash?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Can I just tell you one thing as well? On the paperwork she gives for, like, it's like a rent, like you can pick from what you want to pick for a lease. And on the bottom of it, I think I sent a copy of that to you guys. It says that rent will be trash and sewage will be around $20 to $30. I've been charged $48 in the past. And then, like, this month's 31, and this last month was 31 something. And then, like, it fluctuates so much, it's, like, hard to pay attention to.
Does staff have anything they want to add this time? Okay. I will entertain a motion to close the public hearing.
So moved.
Second.
Okay. All right, we're going to ask you to have a seat. We're going to deliberate. With all the information.
Okay.
You will not be able to give us any more information at this time or to speak. So you will hear our decision by the end of this. Okay? All right. All right. So who wants to go first?
I can pull stuff up on the screen if people want to see it on the big top. Just as a...
I'm sorry, what was that?
I can pull everything up on the screen if people want to see it or are asking for it.
Okay.
Just let me know.
All right. Anybody want to talk about this?
Well, I'd like to.
Go ahead, Paul.
My host isn't ready to.
Yes.
So it appears that we have a number of things that have had some problems in the apartment, but it also is evidenced from the records that we have and the complainant's admission that each of those items has been addressed, with the exception of a window issue, which is still a work in progress. And as we know, coming out of the winter season that we've been in, and weather just turning warm in the last few weeks, it's understandable some of that might be in progress. The other thing is some of you may have information in front of you that reflects the federal HUD documents. I see that the rent increase that we have listed here is reasonably within the guidelines of the federal rent increase as well. Those are my two summary statements at this point.
Okay, thank you. Kelly?
Ask somebody else.
Okay. All right, Jen.
Paul, I'm unsure of what HUD documents you're speaking of. Did we receive that in an email? Where is that?
No, it's not something that was part of the complainant's or the respondent's submittal. It was something that I had provided, I think, in the meeting. And you may not have a copy of it. Federal HUD guidelines for that is general public knowledge is that the HUD rates across the country went up 12.4% overall for 2024.
It states that like 14% is within the mean, the average, without being thought of as legally excessive. Or is legally the right word, guidance accepted? Yeah.
Well, one of the terms used in our guidance is unconscionable, which
I was looking for.
Okay. I am struggling a little bit with the fact that the rent went up 14% the year prior, and they had new trash and sewer fees, and it went up 14% again in 2024. I mean, I looked up what the inflation rates were for those years, and we're looking at, you know, average inflation of 8% between 2022, the average inflation for that year was 8%. Average inflation for 2023 is 4.1%. So, you know, combined, that's 12.43% inflation over those 2 years. You know, Eagle Rock has raised the rents 32.24% over those 2 years. If that's not unconscionable, I'm not sure what is.
Can I interject one thing? Enfield taxes did go up 2 years in a row. Yeah.
And I understand that. Unfortunately, we can't ask the management company what their expense increase was because they're not here tonight. So
we could look that up, but across the board, everybody's taxes went up. Yeah, I'm sure yours taxes went up as well.
Not 32%.
Well, the other thing I think we should also recognize is this hearing is for this year's rent increase, not last year's. We are looking at this year's rent increase, not the cumulative rent increase.
Understood. I understand that.
But this year,
went up over 12%.
Yeah, right. The tax that went up last year, they're paying this year. So that with inflation, it may not be as terrible. And I don't like any rent increases, believe me. Mm-hmm. But I don't think it's that terrible.
It's okay. I mean, I know I didn't get a 14% raise this year. So
neither did I.
You know, and while taxes went up 10%, that is not the totality of their expenses. So to say, you know, taxes went up 10, so the rent goes up 14, one doesn't equate with the other. So, you know, total inflation, not just taxes. Mm-hmm. I'm struggling with the amount of this rent increase.
Well, one of the other things to consider also is the Fed rates for inflation that you're looking at are an adjusted Fed rate. They do not include all of the expenses that corporate or residential America puts up with. It's a very closely monitored but limited renting or inflation rate that's in that calculation. It does not include everything that we all deal with in our everyday life.
Okay, I said my piece, so.
No, that's what we're sitting here listening for. So there is other considerations when they do the increase. It's not just inflation. It's not just taxes. It's the payroll that they have to pay. It is the increasing cost of materials that they have to pay. There's a lot insurance increases. I don't know if you've gotten your insurances, but you've noticed a big increase on that. So there's a lot of considerations that they have to consider too. And a 14% at this point, I don't feel is that much of an increase. They were given notice prior to the increase. There was time that the tenant could have looked for another unit someplace else. There's not always, well, it went up and so I have to pay it. It went up, you're a renter. You have the option of moving. And even if you come to an end of a rental period, you can continue to stay and go on what they call a month-to-month. There is a fee for that, but you can continue to stay there until you find another apartment or house. So it's, and so there's a lot to consider. And then there were the issues, but all the issues have been addressed and they're being taken care of. So to order a window can take up to six weeks to 3 months. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So since the pandemic, it's that timeline is even worse. So that's something we have to think about.
If trash and sewer has been covered by rent for X amount of years back, and now it is not, is that considered technically a raise in rent? Or is it just you're going to be charging more, but you're taking it off of lease and now making it an attached fee?
Right. And
doing that then avoids having to, quote, raise rent by 17%, because you're not. You're including a three, like how Enfield did our sewer fee a few years back. It's not a tax increase, it's now a fee. So taxes stayed the same, but you're paying more.
Right.
That's not technically considered a rent increase, but is it not emotionally a rent increase?
We're not here to talk about emotions.
Yes, yes.
I'm sure they had an attorney do their research on doing the trash and sewer. And who knows, maybe someday, and I don't want to think about it, but maybe someday we're going to have to pay for our trash. We're now paying for our sewers. Because trash has become such a huge expense. Yep. So it's something that, you know, we're all faced with. So, Kelly?
I think the unfortunate reality is that this was a new company coming in, and the original company could have sold because of all these costs going up. We don't know. I mean, I can only speculate. I mean, obviously, adding sewer and trash will increase their cost, but they also got several months pretty much for free without having to pay.
And that went into effect in June of 22, and we're now the end of March 24. So,
well, I think they started getting, according to my notes, they started having to pay that in November of 2022. So they had several months where they weren't being
Right.
It wasn't being charged.
Okay.
That's all I got.
Anybody else? Paul?
If I could.
Sure.
Yes. Another thing to consider that's in our package of information for the 13 points to consider when looking at these types of complaints. Another factor to consider is the amenities and the like charges of similar units in similar atmospheres and similar neighborhoods and so forth. When you look at those figures for this particular residence in this locale with the amenities that are offered, the rent is well, well within a reasonable realm of rent levels. In fact, there are, I would tell you that the rents for one-bedroom apartments in other parts of town, very close to where this hearing is being held, are higher than the rents that are being charged here at Countrywood. So fair and rent and reasonable rent and so forth, all of those factors combined. No one likes to see a rent increase. No one wants to see the taxes go up. But I don't find this particular situation an unconscionable increase at this time, given all those factors that we have to consider, not only the size of the increase, but the factors affecting for the value of the property that's there. I will agree that with what Ian said, that back a year before with the new owners, suddenly they weren't paying for sewer and trash, and now they are. But that took effect in 2022. Again, we're looking at a 2023 rent increase factor. That's already in the contract. It's unfortunate. I think that in our economic times right now, that's what we're all facing. Taxes on our properties, taxes on insurance on our properties. We're all facing the same thing in this. And the one thing that this company's facing that you and I as a resident aren't facing is the tremendous increase in payroll taxes, insurance costs, and benefits that now have to be paid to any company of this size with any number of employees. And those are factors that you and I don't control and the tenant doesn't control, but the company has to come up with those costs somewhere. And this is why when legislation gets passed that says we're going to raise the minimum wage, or we're going to force employers to give sick time, or we're going to force employers to provide benefits and so forth, those are all expenses that have to come from somewhere. And in this type of an environment, unfortunately, that gets passed down to the people that pay the rent. That could be, to Linda's point, that could be some of what's taking place here, because corporate taxes for benefits such as those employee things have gone through the roof over the last couple of years, and some of spending this year is destined to happen again. And that's the unfortunate reality of where we are. Connecticut is not making it any easier to be a renter or a corporation with the current legislation that's been passed in the last 2 years and what's pending this year. And I'll leave it at that.
I got something. Paul, I agree with you. The renter is the end user, and just like any company, any corporation, any costs, the end user ends up paying for it. So one thing, though, to go back on the accounting for the sewer and the trash, I think that in our memo, we should ask that the landlord be a little more transparent with, you know, exactly what they're paying and why, so that it's not such a, it's hard for anybody to budget when you're just not sure exactly how much something's going to be, even if it's off by a little bit more. I want to know what I'm paying for. So I think that if they're using an app, there's got to be a way for them, for the all the residents, to be able to see exactly what they're paying for and why.
I think that's a fair statement. One of the things that comes up is that the complainant mentioned was that the rate changes every year. So we should find out from the respondent, from the management company, why is the rate changes every month? Why is the rent the rate changing every month, because I understood from the contract that it's a flat fee rate based on the number of bedrooms. So water fee is the sewer fee is based on the number of bedrooms. The trash fee is based on the number of bedrooms. So why does that change every month? So that's a good point. Maybe we should put that in the memorandum. I have a feeling, I suspect, I don't know, but I suspect that the reason is because, as you and I know, our quarterly sewer bills change quarterly and may change based on water usage. And certainly trash hauling changes, perhaps seasonally, for these corporations. And if the trash fees each month change depending upon how much trash is hauled out of the complex, then it's divvied up differently. That might rise to why it's different every month. And if the sewer fee is different seasonally because of different water usage rates, the sewer fees change, that could be the other factor there. But that's a good point. We could ask them why it's different, and they can't be more transparent and forthcoming with what to expect for rates.
Down to communication.
Yes.
Okay, looking at the ledger, just doing a quick look, it seems that in the warmer months, the rate of sewer usage goes up, and the highest I see is about $24, $25, but the trash is within $9 to $11 a month. So, and then in the colder months, the sewer rate goes down substantially to about $18, $19 to $14.93, 11. So the water usage goes down, and I know they have a pool on site, and I don't know what other
thing. I bet you I know why. It's because they're paying sewer on water that's going onto the lawn and,
yep,
and into the pool. And the management company, this would actually save them a whole lot of money, and in the end save the residents a whole lot of money. They could get a separate meter and report that to the town, and that would reduce their tax because it's not going into the sewer system.
No.
Yeah, they would get a discharge meter.
Again,
I think it's what it's called.
That's up to management.
And it's not that expensive to put in as you would think it would be. So
right.
I think we should suggest that to them, because in the end it would help help all the residents, because
yep,
it would immediately
reduce their fees.
Right, and it would be more consistent through the year.
Okay. So, and they do get heat, hot water. So there's the pool. They get a lot of amenities here that, and we all know, heating is outrageous today. So, and the electricity is going up. So, and they're asking for more, of course. So really, this is not that big of an increase, and yes, it would hit all, I mean, all of these costs are hitting us in the pocketbook. So, anything else? Anybody else would like to?
That's all I have.
Okay, I will entertain a motion on this.
I'd like to make a motion that we close the deliberations. I will type up the memo, send the draft to the commission, and I think we have some time before we have to.
We have 21 days.
Correct.
We have 21 days. So we'll have 21 days to.
So I did a motion.
Oh, wait.
Second.
Thank you, Ian.
Okay. All right. Sorry, now I can talk to you. You will receive something in writing in 21 days. At this time, we feel that the 14% is well within reason. And please keep in contact with Cindy, and we will contact the management company to ensure that your window does get fixed. But at this time, we feel the 14% is within reason, and all your other issues have been addressed. If you have any problems with the management company, please notify Cindy immediately. Okay? All right. Thank you.
Motion to adjourn. Oh, wait, we didn't vote on. We got to vote on the deliberations ending.
All right. And if you vote in a negative, the motion is positive. If you vote against the motion, you have to give us a reason why. Okay? So, roll call.
What's the motion?
The motion was to close deliberations.
Was to close the deliberations.
Right, so.
Okay. So
we're not making a motion on the
decision. We're not making a motion on the decision yet.
No. So we can make a motion on the decision.
So it's already been a motion, second, all in favor?
Aye to close.
Okay.
Aye.
So now we need a motion on the increase, if we feel that it's positive or negative.
Are you going to have to help me on how we should frame the motion? Because it's got to be positive.
So the motion is being made that it's fine. Like, we're not suggesting it be lowered. We're suggesting it stay the same.
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
Yes.
Okay. So what? Ian made the motion.
Oh. That was a question.
No. No. Okay. Say it again.
Then the motion is being made that we are suggesting that the rent increase is not unconscionable.
Right. It's reasonable.
It is reasonable under statute.
Okay.
Okay. Yes. All right.
And I'll second it.
All right. And roll call.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay.
Usually we
We're
just say
aye. We're used to this.
Yes, I know. Used to somebody else doing it. Kelly Hemmler, yes. The motion is that it's reasonable.
Right.
Okay. Yes. Ian Graves?
Yes.
Jennifer Briette?
Yes.
Linda DeGray?
Yes.
Paul Janusewski. Janusewski.
Yes.
Okay. Motion passes.
Okay. All right. Since we have nothing else on our agenda, I will entertain a motion to adjourn.
Motion.
Second.
Oh. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right.